Derek! Get!
Not again, Jordy.
Derek! Get!
Stop withdrawing stuff, Jordy.
Derek! Get! Damn it, Jordy! Damn it! Energetic! Get! No! What the fuck, Jordy?
Hey guys, Jordy here for Cinecom.net and whoa! Derek, damn it! You're watching Copycat Friday, a weekly series where we tackle an effect from a film or music video and try to find a simple way to recreate that. And as we all know, QUICKSILVER is fast. We can't see him running around, but if we look through his eyes, the world actually goes super slow. To make it ourselves easy, we took two shots of the scene. One is where I fired the gun in a long shot, and the other one is a medium shot where Lorenzo comes into play and turns the bullet around. For the first one, we took two shots from a tripod. The first one is where I actually fired the gun. And by the way, guys, this is a fake gun. We are also adults and are very conscious when working with such movie props. Do not never play with real guns. So I fire the gun and move into a slow motion state. And Janek does the same thing. He throws some stuff that he was holding in the air and also moved very slow at that point. And you can shoot this in slow motion if you like. It will make the fake slow movements less visible. And then we took a shot of that bullet in that same environment from a distance. And this way the lighting and everything is the same. We drill a hole into an empty bullet. Don't do this in a real one. So that we could stick a wire into this. And this will help us to cut out that bullet better. Then for the second shot, we're going to film again from a tripod. There are again two shots that we'll need. The first one is where Janek does the slow motion move. And he's doing a great job at that, as you can see. Now I'm holding that bullet still on the point where I want Lorenzo to turn it around. And obviously, we also have Lorenzo himself in the scene. And finally, also make an empty shot to remove that wire and my hands. We've got all of our shots, we can bring it now into Adobe Premiere Pro, but there will be some advanced techniques, so if you're just starting out, I highly recommend to follow our beginner's class to Adobe Premiere Pro. It's our 6th generation Premiere Pro class, meaning that we have gathered a ton of feedback over the years and designed a unique learning path that is excited, interactive, and like many of our reviews say, time flies by, and without knowing, I was already editing complete videos. You can check this one or one of our other courses out by following the first link in the description below. Now let's start off by placing your first shot on the bottom of your timeline. We're going to bring the stuff that Janek throws in the air to an extreme slow motion. So for every object, I'm going to duplicate the layer, plus one extra that is going to function as an empty layer. Now disable the output for all the duplications except for that bottom track. Go to the beginning of your timeline, right-click and add a frame hold. On this empty layer, we're going to create a mask so that it doesn't cover any subjects or other moving parts. Then for the stuff in the air, look for a point where they float nicely. Right-click and add a frame hold. Mask out the objects and animate the position property to make them float super slow through the air. And since we're freezing time, I'm going to expand the keyframe curve of the position and pull the lever of the first keyframe to the right and also up. And this way I'm telling to the animation to start very fast and gradually slow down. Do this for all the floating objects. Freeze frame, mask, and the animation of the position. The bullet was a separate shot, so I'm adding that clip to the timeline and mask around that bullet. Make sure to add a frame hold to it as well. We can now animate the position of that bullet so that it comes out of the gun. Like before, I'm also pulling the lever up and to the right of the first keyframe to make it start fast. However, bullets go really fast, so that's why I'm going to nest the bullet into a new sequence. On this nested sequence, I'm going to change the FX to time remapping speed. And this allows me to add a keyframe with the pen tool where the bullet is slowing down. And this will divide the clip into a left and right part. The left part where the bullet comes out of the loop has to go really fast. So I'm pulling that speed line up. You can then also expand the keyframe to make the speed go again gradually from fast to normal. Finally, add your favorite muzzle flash to the gun, and you can get these effects from stock libraries such as video blocks or just search the web. So that was the first part. Now let's start with a new sequence to create the turning bullet. Start off by placing your empty shot in the bottom of the timeline. On top of that goes the normal shot. I took the floating objects above Janik from my first shot. You can simply drag them out of your first created sequence. You probably want to scale and reposition them, and make sure that your keyframes are adjusted as well. For the convenience, I'm going to nest these floating objects and place them on a higher track in the timeline. Now let's create that bullet again. Duplicate the normal shot and add a frame hold right before Lorenzo is touching that bullet. Remove the stuff on the left and move the right part to the left. Make sure to trim the clip so that it stops right before Lorenzo touches that bullet. Then go ahead and mask out the bullet. Like before, animate the position of that bullet, and important here is that you start from the last position where the bullet is currently at. Then move back in time and pull the bullet to the left. When Lorenzo releases the bullet, we're going to do the exact same thing. Duplicate the normal layer, look for the point where he's about to release, and here you want to add a frame hold. Remove the left part, mask out the bullet, and animate its position going back into the opposite direction. And finally, we're going to work on the original clip in track number 2. Create a mask on it, but make sure that you do this around the subjects. In other words, my hand where I hold that bullet should be removed. Enable animation for the mask path and change it over time so that it follows Lorenzo's hands. As he comes in front of the bullet, you have to mask more precise around his finger and the bullet. Don't show the wire. Now this takes some time, but once it's done, you can enjoy an awesome video. How to stop a bullet from killing people. Again, guys, guns are no toys. The entire process will work exactly the same if you would throw a ball or any other object. It doesn't have to be a gun. Thank you guys so much for watching. And like always, stay creative. Let's throw some ladders.
Lorenzo!
Lorenzo!
Lopen, 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 lopen.
Durf niet te vallen, hè.
Janne kan ladder gooien naar mij.
Jordy hier voor Cinecom.net en oh! Janik, damn it!